It's a well-known problem that old NES light gun games won't work on modern TVs. For a long time, I assumed this was entirely due to the display lag that TVs have now, until about the mid-2000s, consumer televisions used a cathode ray tube design that showed the image instantaneously. In fact, it was so instantaneous that it showed the image line by line in real time as it was received from the NES. Modern televisions don't do this anymore. Instead, there's a memory buffer that fills up line by line, and it waits until that buffer is full with a complete frame before showing it to you all at once. Even though there are several milliseconds between when the top and bottom of the image is received, the TV doesn't send out the light until at least the end of the frame. Often there's additional buffering and processing steps that cause even more delay. And with non-interactive video, this isn't really a problem. The audio can easily be delayed to stay in sync, and there's really no negative consequences for it. But with games, this is a big problem. The latency introduced means you have less time to react to what you see on the screen. Lag is a major issue for a lot of video games, and a big topic of its own. But in this case, we don't even need to consider the relatively slow reaction time of a human. For a game like Duck Hunt to work, its software expects to be able to see that stream of light from the TV to the Zapper into the NES at the very same time it generates the video signal for it. If you've played the game, you've probably noticed the white box that flashes under the duck when you pull the trigger. The game is checking if the Zapper sees white or black at that instant. A few years ago, I thought maybe I could solve this problem by modifying the software. What if Duck Hunt was designed for display lag? I could wait a few extra frames and check the Zapper a little bit later to see if it sees that white square, but accounting for the delay. I did modify the game at the time, but no luck. That's when I learned about the second issue. The NES Zapper can't even see light from my television. At all. When my attempt to add lag compensation to Duck Hunt didn't work, I made a few test programs just to get more of an idea of how the light gun functions. It couldn't see any kind of light from my TV, and I wasn't sure if my Zapper was broken, but then I discovered I could get some signal from a compact fluorescent light bulb, which was weird. At this time, I was informed by some helpful members of the NES Dev forums that the Zapper has a built-in filter designed only to see the very rapidly changing light source of a CRT. This filter is tuned roughly to 15,000 Hz, which is about the time it takes the light beam of a CRT to trace across a screen. The light from a CRT goes from dark to bright extremely fast. The difference between an LCD TV and a CRT isn't readily apparent to the human eye, but the actual light levels from a CRT screen change about 1,000 times faster than an LCD. To a machine like the NES, this is night and day. Its CPU can easily check the Zapper report 1,000 times in a single frame. This seems like a very good design for Nintendo. All consumer TVs at the time were CRTs, and this was a great way to ensure that it didn't get false signals from light bulbs or shadows or other things happening in the room. The light filter made it a more reliable instrument. But for me, in 2015, this was the end of the road. I could modify the software to compensate for the lag, but I couldn't get the Zapper to work without modifying its hardware. That killed the idea for me. It's easy to distribute software patches, but most people aren't ready to mess with the electronics. I decided it wasn't worth proceeding and put the idea away. In between then and now, a few interesting things have happened. There was the LightGunVerter project that uses a modern pointer device such as a Wiimote in tandem with the original NES video signal to recreate what the Zapper would have seen without actually having to wait for the light from the television to get to it. This is actually a perfect solution, which doesn't require any software compensation for lag either. Its implementation is open source too, but you have to build the hardware yourself. Its author has started selling a ready-made version, but it's currently sold out and waiting for resupply. Earlier this year, we had the Modern Mallard Kickstarter, which offered an easy-to-install replacement component for your NES Zapper, alongside an interesting Game Genie-style plug-in board to patch your original Duck Hunt cartridge. I was personally very interested in this easy Zapper modification, but it was only offered as a complete package, and I think it seemed too expensive for most people, myself included. The Kickstarter campaign did not succeed, unfortunately. And finally, just a few weeks ago, someone posted their project called NES LCD Mod to patch the Duck Hunt software for display lag, seemingly unaware of the Zapper's inability to work with an LCD television. This took me by surprise, because it was the same idea I'd tried years earlier, but here was video of it working for them. Except, I noticed their light gun was different. They were actually using a clone system, and apparently there was no CRT filter in this gun. Their light gun seemed to come from an old Russian clone system, but I wondered if there were any recent Zapper replacements for the North American NES that might work too. I quickly found the Tomee Zapp Gun sold by Hyperkin. This is a very inexpensive clone, and I figured it was worth taking a chance on. When finally arrived, I gave it a test, and yes, it works! Finally, I had a light gun I could use with my NES, despite no longer owning a CRT television. It doesn't work with the original software, but software is easy to modify. And if you've got a flash cartridge like the Power Pack or EverDrive N8, you can run it on that. I didn't even need to revive my own work on Duck Hunt lag compensation because this newly available NES LCD mod project had already done a good job with it. So here we go! Duck Hunt is working again on my LCD TV in 2018. Isn't that a wonderful thing? For links and information, please read the video description. Thanks for listening.